What's up, everybody? I hope you're having a wonderful 2021 so far. I believe that this is the year for the church to make an impact. And I know we can say that about every year, but I really want us to take it serious. I want us to approach 2021 like we've never approached any other year, but let us be about God's business. Let us be about reaching people, bringing people into the kingdom, not even growing a church, but growing God's kingdom, getting people saved, making disciples. And what we need to realize is that responsibility has been given to all of us. We know what the book of Corinthians says, that we've all been given this ministry of reconciliation. You, me, everybody that believes in him is supposed to be reconciling people back to God, bringing people home and reestablishing them in their faith and in a relationship with Jesus Christ. Today, I want to focus on one of the best ways that you and I can do that in 2021, and it's about the way we live our lives. I want you to ask yourself a question. Are you living in a way that makes Jesus look good or makes Jesus look bad? You have to understand, a lot of people will only see Jesus when they see you. And so we have to make sure that we're a good representation of Jesus. And when they look at us, they see the goodness of God, they see the love of God, they see the sacrifice of Jesus, they see everything that he's done for them. And you communicate that in lifestyle Christianity. I love the way Todd White says that, lifestyle Christianity. And so we need to live a life that points people to Jesus, amen? And so let's look at a couple of scriptures. Let's start over here in 1 Peter. We're gonna read in chapter 2, verses 11 through 12. It says, "Dear brothers and sisters, you are foreigners and aliens here. So I warn you, keep away from evil desires because they fight against your very souls." Verse 12, "Be careful how you live among your unbelieving neighbors. Even if they accuse you of doing wrong, they will see your honorable behavior and they will believe and give honor to God." So what is the process for an unbeliever to come to God and give honor to him? Well, the Bible here says your honorable lifestyle will bring them to God. We know what it says in the book of Matthew, where it talks in chapter 5, how you are the light of the world. You are the salt of this earth. And then verse 16 says, "Let your good deeds shine out before everyone so they will praise your heavenly Father." How you treat people and how you conduct your life, it will lead people to Jesus Christ. You don't always have to do it with your words, but lifestyle Christianity is important and it makes a big difference. So how do we begin to do this? Well, let's go over to Psalms 37. I'm so glad you asked that question. I got it right here for you. I hope y'all are doing so awesome. So listen, this is how we live a life that is honorable before Jesus Christ. There is no other way to do this. Psalms 37, verse 3, "Trust in the Lord." Now listen to this. "Trust in the Lord and do good." So we see he's painting a picture here. In order to do good, you're gonna have to trust God. Now, why is it that way? Because if we were just moved by everything that we saw, if we were just moved by everything we heard, it would be impossible for us to do good. Because everything we see in this world can be so discouraging, everything we hear on the news can be so discouraging, and if we let that stuff affect us, it will affect our behavior. It will turn us against the people that Jesus died for. And so the way we keep from turning against one another and against people that Jesus died for is by trusting in him. And when we trust in God, it gives us this divine ability to look at every single individual as a son or a daughter of the Most High, a son or a daughter of the one who died and gave his life for them. You represent Jesus to this lost and dying world. And one of the best ways to do that is through your behavior, and your behavior can only reflect him if you trust in him. And so we have to trust in the Lord and do good. Then you'll live safely in the land and prosper. Take delight in the Lord, and he will give you the heart's desire. Now here we go, verse 5. "Commit everything you do to the Lord. Trust him and he will help you." Listen, we know Zechariah 4, it says that's not by might nor by strength, but by his spirit, says the Lord. If you're gonna do good in the land that we live in today, you're gonna have to trust the Lord. You need his help, you need his power. I encourage you. And in no time, like right now, do we need to have this relationship with God? Do we need to be trusting in him every day of our lives so we can live lives that are honorable before the Lord, so our lives can be a witness to the world that we live in. We love you guys so much. I encourage you to just reach out to your neighbors, reach out to your friends, be a blessing unto them, and be the light of Jesus Christ in this lost world. We love you, and we'll see you next time.